Mark me.
I will.
My hour has almost come, when I to sulphurous and tormenting flames must render up myself.
Alas, poor ghost.
Pity me not, but lend thy serious hearing to what I shall unfold.
Speak, I am bound to hear.
I am thy father's spirit, doomed for a certain term to walk the night.
Oh, God!
Revenge is foul and most unnatural murder!
Murder?
Murder most foul, as in the best it is. The serpent that did sting thy father's life now wears his crown.
Oh, my prophetic soul! My uncle?
How now, Ophelia? What's the matter?
Oh, my lord, I've been so frightened.
With what in the name of God?
Lord Hamlet, to speak of horrors, he comes before me.
Mad for thy love?
My lord, I do not know, but I truly do fear it.
What said he?
He raised a sigh so piteous and profound, he went out o'doors without their help.
Come, go with me. I will go seek the king. This is the very ecstasy of love. That hath made him mad.
He hath told me, my dear Gertrude, that he hath found the head and source of your son's distemperment.
I doubt it is no other than the main, his father's death and our overhasty marriage.
He is mad. Tis true, tis true, tis pity. You know, sometimes he walks 4 hours together here in the lobby.
So he does indeed.
At such a time, I'll loose my daughter to him. Be you and I behind an arras then. Mark the encounter. If he love her not, and be not from his reason fallen thereon, let me be no assistant for estate, but keep a farm and carters.
I did love you once.
Indeed, my lord, you made me believe so.
Ha! I loved you not.
I was the one more deceived.
Get thee to a nunnery! Get thee to a nunnery!
To be or not to be, that is the question. Whether 'tis nobler in the mind to suffer the slings and arrows of outrageous fortune, or to take arms against a sea of troubles, and by opposing end them, to die, to sleep, no more, and by a sleep to say we end the heartache and the thousand natural shocks that flesh is heir to, 'tis a consummation devoutly to be wished. To die, to sleep, perchance to dream. Aye, there's the rub. For in that sleep of death what dreams may come, when we have shuffled off this mortal coil, must give us pause. There's the respect that makes calamity of so long life. For who would bear the whips and scorns of time, the oppressor's wrong, the proud man's contumely, the pangs of despised love, the law's delay, the insolence of office, and the spurns that patient merit of the unworthy takes. When he himself might his quietus make, with a bare bodkin, who would fardels bear, to grunt and sweat under a weary life, but that the dread of something after death, the undiscovered country, from whose born no traveller returns, puzzles the will, and makes us rather bear those ills we have, than fly to others that we know not of. Thus conscience does make cowards of us all, and thus the native hue of resolution is sicklied over with the pale cast of thought, and enterprises of great pitch and moment. With this regard, their currents turn awry, and lose the name of action.
What do you call this play?
It is called The Mousetrap.
Thank you. Give me some light! Away!
Poison cup. It is too late.
I dare not drink, madam. By and by.
Treason!
Spirit! No! You mustn't drink. Please.